Look whom we have got with us in our physics class today. We have got Tom and Jerry, and they will help us study vectors and scalars. Now one day, Tom comes to know that Jerry is standing at a distance of 2 meters from this traffic signal, and Tom is really excited that finally he will be able to get hold of Jerry. But when he reaches here, he's really confused. Can you guess why? Yes, because Jerry could be standing here or here or here. And this time also, Tom missed out on Jerry. Although he had some information about Jerry's position, he did not have complete information about Jerry's position. However, if Tom would have known that Jerry is standing 2 meters towards east from the traffic signal, then he would have got a complete picture of Jerry's exact position. And in this case, he would have been able to get hold of Jerry. So what we see? Well, we see that in this case, only the numerical value or magnitude, which is 2 meters here, is not sufficient to describe the complete position of Jerry. We also require direction, which is east. So along with the numerical value or magnitude, we require direction to describe Jerry's position. Now if I tell you that mass of Jerry is 1 kg facing east, or temperature of Jerry is 37 degrees Celsius in the northwest direction, well, do you find something strange about it? Yes. Actually, the directions which I am mentioning here, that is the east and the northwest direction, these directions are irrelevant, because mass in east or mass in west, it's all the same. So there are certain quantities like mass and temperature here for which only the magnitude is sufficient to describe them completely. Now talking of quantities, what kind of quantities are we actually talking about? Well, we are talking about physical quantities. What are physical quantities? Physical quantities are the quantities which can be measured. So any quantity which can be measured is a physical quantity. For example, length, because it can be measured with the help of a meter rule. Temperature is a physical quantity, because it can be measured with the help of a thermometer. Volume is a physical quantity, because it can be measured with the help of a measuring cylinder. So any quantity which you can measure is called a physical quantities. And we have studied 2 types of physical quantities here. First is quantities which can be completely described by their magnitude only, and such quantities are called scalar quantities, like we had seen in the case of mass and temperature. Second is quantities which require both magnitude and direction for their complete description. Such quantities are called vector quantities. For example, Jerry's position, which we had seen earlier. Well, if you still haven't understood what are vector quantities, you need not worry. Listen to this incident carefully. Now one day, Jerry comes to know that Tom is running really fast. So should Jerry be scared? Let's see. Well, if this is the case and Tom is running away from Jerry, then obviously, there is no reason for Jerry to worry. However, if the situation is like this and Tom is running towards Jerry, then yes, Jerry should really be scared, as Tom might get hold of him and eat him up. So we see that in this case also, the direction in which Tom is running becomes really important. So we have studied that vector quantities require both magnitude and direction for their complete description. And having studied what are vector quantities, let us study how do we represent vector quantities. So if V is a vector quantity, it is represented as V with an arrow on top. And an important point to note here is that this arrow does not have anything to do with the direction of V. That is, the direction of vector quantity V can be to the north, south, east, west, anywhere, but we always draw the arrow pointing to the right hand side. In books, you may find vector quantities typed in bold letters. So let me give you a quick recap of what are scalar quantities and what are vector quantities. Scalar quantities are the quantities which require magnitude only, and vector quantities are the quantities which require both magnitude and direction.